see also a deliverance are taking place, and here we already see that the pain is coming, the manifestation. Why? This is a demonic pain. Why? Because demons don't like water. And then we take the time, so she don't speak in tongues yet, and she don't speak, but they're going to speak because there's freedom here. And this is what the promise is: repent, get baptized, and you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. And just start. There's promises for you, your children, and everyone who's far off. If we repent and get baptized, we shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. That is what it's all about.
Let go. Pain go. Come out right now. Let go. All pain go. All hurt go. Freedom, let go. Every lie go right now. Come out right now. Every lie. Leave her. Holy Spirit, come. Da. Speak. Louder. Come on,
this is what it is, this is how it should look like. Down in the water, come up, and the Holy Spirit come right. How was it? Come on, stand up. How was it?
Wonderful!
And I've seen so many people who have been longing for the Holy Spirit for years, and they're not been able to receive the Holy Spirit. But when then hear the true gospel, repenting and baptized, the Holy Spirit is coming so powerful. So this is how we need to go back to what we see in the book of Acts and the order we see there. So it's so beautiful. You.
Can you say, come here, how was it? Can you say, how did it feel like? What happened?
I feel so free.
You are free.
And we can see the next person, he also don't speak in tongues, and we had a little talk about what do you need freedom for, and then when we talk with him about what you need freedom for, and we bury that old life, wash away the sins and pray for freedom, we will often see also a deliverance are taking place, and here we already see that the pain is coming, the manifestation. Why?
Demons don't like water. And you need to come and preach radical faith, radical repentance, and then baptism in water. So sometimes people ask, why do you cast demons out under the baptism? Sometimes it's before, like we see here, and sometimes under and after.
So this is what it is. You have never seen that in church before, maybe. But you don't see this if you only preach baptism as just a symbol. If you preach baptism as just a symbol, you will not see this. But this is how it is. And sometimes they get delivered after and under and so on.
Are you ready? Okay, we're ready to get baptized to Christ. Ready? Go on the other side. Ready?
Yes.
Sit down. Okay, come over here.
Are you ready to get baptized to Jesus Christ?
Yes, sir.
Then we baptize you to Christ. Die with Christ. Rise up with Christ.
Okay, last video. Come on right now.
Come on. go.
And what you see here, what you see here is she tried to speak in tongues, and there is also already working her, but it's not coming up. It's like she's there, and then those demons are blocking. What you she's having when she coughs, when the last thing go out, you see peace, and then she just be fluent in tongues. And what you saw before, you can see it in her face, something, peace came. Now there's just a lot of emotion and a lot of things going on.
Just relax.
Hi, hey, look at me, hi.
Just relax.
Oh.
Just relax.
Oh. Hallelujah. Amen.
Lord, thank you. Woo! Thank you, Jesus.
How was that?
Oh, thank God.
Yeah.
Thank God.
And what you saw before, there was, and then it becomes torn. Still a lot of emotions, but a lot of, yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah.
You love it? New life. Come on, this is real. See this video. See this video. This is powerful.
Yes, let's go.
And again, what you see here, every Baptist is different. My Baptist did not look like that. But this is what we see. So every person are different. Woo! Hallelujah! Holy Spirit. Hey, I want to recommend a book about this. Remember this book. Maybe you heard about it. The name of the book is The Bible. This is what we read in the Bible. People repent, they get baptized, they get delivered, they get healed, and they receive the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah.